Many great personalities are forgotten and faded away in the history of Indian independence. In this moment, let's take a minute or two just to pay them a tribute by retracing their bravery and act of heroism. Gandhiburi. Born on 19th October 1870. Place of birth, Tamluk, Bengal Presidency, British India. She was an Indian revolutionist who participated in the Indian independence movement. She was born in a small village of Hogal near Tamluk in 1869. Being a daughter of poor peasant, she did not receive any formal education. She was married early and became widowed at the age of 18 without bearing any offsprings. In 1905, she became actively interested in the Indian independence movement as a Gandhian. She took part in the civil disobedience movement and was arrested for breaking the Salt Act. In 1933, she attended the Subdivisional Congress Conference at Serampore and was injured in the ensuing baton charge by the police. As a part of Quit India movement, members of the Congress planned to take over the various police stations of Medinipore district and other government offices. This was to be a step in overthrowing the British government in the district. Hazra, who was 71 years at that time, led a procession of 6,000 supporters. When the procession reached the outskirts of town, they were ordered to disband under the section 144 of IPC by the Crown Police. As she stepped forward, Hazra was shot once. She continued to advance the tricolor flag, leaving all the supporters behind. The police shot her three times. She continued marching despite wounds to the forehead and both hands. Her final words were, "Vande Mataram." She died with the flag of Indian National Congress held high and still flying. After independence, numerous schools, colonies and streets were named after Hazra. The first statue of a woman to put up in Kolkata was Hazra's in 1977, a place where she was killed in Tamluk. In 2002, postage stamps were released with Mathangi Hazra's likeness. Let us get to know about some more heroes in the upcoming videos.